All right, let's get started. Welcome, guys. Happy Friday evening here in the UK. Hope you guys had a good week. I know it's been a great week in terms of fundamentals. Well, not so much the first half of the week, but it's definitely the last 2 days, right? So Thursday and Friday, arguably today, question mark, but yesterday definitely we saw some amazing movement, okay, from the CPI data that came out, which we look at. I've got a couple of pairs. Let me actually just go over to So essentially, I've got three chef pairs, and then I've got one index that we can look at. I did this up. So this was NU. I think we looked at NU last time we were there or something. It gave us a nice accumulation, but essentially turned into a redistro, and then it went, and we took our dislo today. So yeah, that's gone now. Cool. This is not here. Let's go over the one that I missed. Structure. Let's go over the one that I missed, which was GBP share. Cool. I don't need to go far, but essentially we're bearish times three on this. Lower time frame, higher time frame, and intraday we're bearish. You can just see that. I'll stick on the 1 hour for now, and essentially I want to work inside this redistro here. So last week, last Thursday, we made this new low. So I knew my game plan coming into this week. So this was Thursday, Friday. So I knew my game plan coming into this week was to see if we could come back up into here, or ideally somewhere like a premium pricing, so we could distribute and then we could go down. So coming into this week, given that we was bearish times three, I just wanted to see some sort of manipulation, and then I would be getting ready for shorts. So let's see how this week portrays itself, and we're gonna go to here. Okay, so essentially, so that was Friday. Coming into this week, there was a couple of things I was seeing. So So now that we found our leg, let me just down here. So this is essentially our leg, right? This is what we're working on. Yeah, let me just put it on there. It's not low time frame, but it's just because of a different color. Okay. Yeah, this is the leg that we're working off. Couple of things that we can play with. So we know this is the area that we'll be looking for shorts. We're currently in the 50 already. And then if you wanted to, because this is a news here for GBP, we could also go and see what it is. So that's the 2nd of August. Oh, sorry, it was Chef News that what came out. Essentially, we didn't even get much. But it was Chef News that came out. So this is also an area that we could look at. I'm not sure if you can find a full candle in there. Let's go and see. My dear thing. So maybe a 2 hour. Oh, should quite like 100. There you go. So, see if you can find some sort of confidence in it. Yeah, so I like that 50 is in line with that 80. And then the last thing that I would personally do is I'll throw a fib in there just to see if we're kind of getting into the premium. And definitely we can see a lot of confluence inside this area. And then this is the area that I'll be looking and waiting for. Matter of fact, I actually had the limits in there. Bearish extreme. Okay. So I personally had the limits in here coming up for this week. Given that we was bearish times three and yeah, given that it was bearish times three and then we had this nice distro with manipulation and a break. So this was enough for me to go and place a limit in here to see if it could carry on going down. At the same time, I was then watching price coming into this to see if we could get a break of order flow and then to see if we could catch anything in here. So coming up here, I then started to watch price retracement. Okay, so here I just needed two couple of things to go ahead and break. I either needed that or this. Because this is fairly equal highs here. So I needed either to see some sort of manipulation to the upside, which would then get us in, more into that premium pricing to go down, or give us a break and then we can catch the redistro, playing off that 50 to go down with this. So just keep watching price. Not yet. Cool. And then we get to Thursday. We get to Thursday and then we also get this break here. Just before that, so this was when the news came out. Well, let's go back right here. So let me also put in this, and let's drop back down to like a 5 minute. Cool. So when we saw this, so we're still playing inside this leg. This is still what was maintaining that retracement leg. But then having seen this, I quite liked how we was distributing and then we was coming into here. So essentially before news, I wanted to see if we could get some sort of manipulation and then a break. And then I was gonna try to catch that. And if I stay on the 3 minute, you would be able to see this clearly. Oh, sorry. So there is the Asian manipulation, right? And again, where I like this micro distro in here. There is this Asian manipulation here that takes out both Asia and London, and then we get this here. And then
What's up? What's
I
up?
again, hey man, what's up, man? You good?
Yeah, man, not bad, not bad. Sorry, I'm late, man. Sorry, I'm late.
No worries, bro, no worries. So when we got this break, this was the news. Let me go back once more. And then, so essentially, when I saw that, and I didn't like the fact that, hold on, I didn't like the fact that this didn't really break, but I just threw a fib from here to here, and I was watching that 50%. I was watching that 50%. I had a limit sitting at the 80, just there. And when I looked at this, just to go, this would be my first low here because we still needed to break that retracement leg from here, right? So this would be my first low from that 80. That would have been your 10 to 1, which this is what allowed me to place that limit. And then the second one would be to still go and make this major low here, which would have given you 22 to 1. So that's what allowed me to go ahead and place that limit. Now, when we drop back, So all I needed to do now was to wait for the retracement to start. And when I start seeing that, I then threw another fib from this low to this high. And then just waited. Okay, so I threw that to see if we found some confluences, but didn't want any. The only thing that I guess we had was somewhere up here, but I already had that limit on. So price comes into that 50. Now I didn't think anything of it. I didn't do anything, because essentially I had this whole area here. Okay, I looked into this. There was imbalance. There was the nice, essentially the FU candle was sitting here with the break. Well, the break here, not here. And that's what I was waiting for. At the same time, the reason why I missed this, the reason why this is in my missed folder is because I was watching these two. So I think I want to say at that time I was already in NSHF, NASHF, and that's why I just had a limit in there, and then I was watching ASHF more closely. Cool. So let's see what happens here and where the trade could have been. So price reacts from that 50% there, and then off it goes to make a new low, and then takes out this low as well. So a couple of things that we could have done. Could have played the whole redistro here. The limit for me, that's at that time, that would be deleted. And then
One
essentially
sec,
this,
JK.
yeah.
Just to double check, is this session being recorded? Oh yeah,
Yeah,
top
bro.
man. Top man. Cheers, mate.
So this is this is that leg, and then we went ahead and we broke that. So now we could have done the whole thing from here to here, and then we know now this is what's maintaining our lowest form of order flow, right? Because we went and we made that break. So essentially what we could have played was in here. From that to that, and you could have thrown a very small risk from that 80 to there. And again, your first target would still be this. That would also give you a 10 to 1. And then your second target would be that low here. Okay, let's look at what happens inside there. Price would come in at 3:20 UK time. So obviously work out, but that would still be this essentially 2 hours after New York open. So you would still be in, and then see what happens there. So essentially this would have been a break for you to see if you could reduce some more risk, but you're already sitting at around a 4 pips stop loss. I personally, I know I would go here to reduce risk, and in the next leg down, I'll go to break even. And essentially, price just fell. My alert here would go off. That would say reduce risk. I would definitely take some partials here, whether price would come up or not. If price comes up, perfect. If it doesn't, then leave it. At the same time, there is also this area in here that we could play out of. So if we haven't deleted that limit in there, that limit would definitely be gone by now. And then we could then, after reducing risk, we could throw the reduced risk into here just to see if we can carry in on. But at this point, I would like this to break. If this breaks, then a limit here would be valid for me. Reason being is because when we look at our next cycle, we know that this is our distro, we know this is our redistro, and this is the SE that causes this break. So if this breaks, I can throw a little limit in that 80 here. At the same time, I would throw back my limit that was sitting here with the stop loss here. Because the way I see this has mitigated that. So the only thing that hasn't been mitigated is that micro in there and is that 80 in here. So there's the break. At this time, so you take partial on the first one. Which would be sitting at 10 to 1. And then, as I say, we go back to that 3 minute. Throw this limit back on. And then with this reduced risk here, you throw the same one. What is it? Sorry, the same one down here with this. And then the third thing you could do is you could then wait for a micro in there because there's such a gap between this and that entry there. So you would watch the micro in there. And then let's just see what happens Friday. So you go and you then go into Asia. Pretty much nothing there. Still nothing. And ideally, I'll be looking if I could get into something before news. Oops. If we can get into something before news, that would be great. Just so then we could trade manage it, right? We could go to break even, and then we could sit with it. Cool. This limit here for me is still on, as long as we don't go and we don't break this. Okay. The moment we go and we break this, for example, this leg is now done, and then we're now focusing on this leg. So this limit is still there, simply because this could just be a shakeout to then come up. So we don't know that. Yeah, so now let's just watch what happens in there. Coming up into Frankfurt Open. And you know, I quite like what we get in here. Really nice. So this is something that I was watching. And I had a limit up here. Sorry, not a limit. I had an alert. Reason being is because I wanted to see some sort of manipulation. Okay, I wanted to see if price breaks this. Like that, okay. And the reason why I didn't have a limit on here is because I never had a reduced risk because I never took this trade. This I would only throw my reduced risk on, and then I'll put new risk back on this one, okay? Because this is the riskier play. So whatever reduced risk as a re-entry, this would tap you in here or here. And then how I would personally trade manage this if you were in, once we make this low, I'll go to reduce risk on this one. Why is this? Okay. That's what we'll be sitting on. And again, same thing with this one. The target would then be to go and make this new low, but then at the same time, we'll be holding for this low. And again, as I said, I never got that alert that says price gave us a manipulation. I think my alert is still there. And then prices dropped.
Just to double check, GK.
Yeah.
So this entry right now, the most recent entry, that's off the 80% of basically the LPSY to the left.
Yeah, this one here.
Right. Gotcha.
Yeah. And even this one looks like it might get clapped, but at the most it gave you a close to 10 to 1. So this one you would already bank to 10 to 1 partials, and then you would got a 10 to 1 here partials as well. But again, I would have only allowed myself to get in, especially on a Friday, if this gave us a third drive and a break, and then I'll get in. Okay. Because the area, it was pro trying, everything made sense. It just didn't give us that break. So
Can I just
that's that.
ask another question, bro?
Yeah, yeah.
I know I missed this. I didn't want to interrupt you like a while ago, but obviously we're seeing the distro. Let me get the annotation up quick. This distro up here, what is this wick? Is it news or something that mitigates it?
This is the CPI data that came out.
Oh, of course, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, this is the CPI data that came out yesterday.
So essentially that entry, the first initial entry, is the 80% off that. Or the attempt to.
This one here?
So did you get an entry off that?
No. So this is okay. So this is under my missed backtest,
Mm. Yeah.
because I was watching this too.
Right.
But how I guess I'm seeing it now and how it played out, my play would have been to take this one, is what I'm trying to say.
Just wait for
Especially
further confirmation.
after we made this low, and after we took out this, this should have been something that I should have threw something back on, simply out of this and out of this.
Understood. Yeah.
Yeah, and even if this was a, I don't know, let's just say half of $50, right? Half of $50 that you would throw at this, at most you would be sitting around 250, bro. So 250 out of 10 to 1, just under $300. So you that's I guess that's all right, you know.
Yeah.
And then of course you would take partials there, but then you would let the rest run or whatever. So that was that. That's how I guess I would have played it if I was watching this live. I mean, I did, but at the same time I wasn't because I was paying attention to the other two. But yeah, any questions on this in terms of where we were, what did we do, and whatnot?
No, it's pretty straightforward, bro. Yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty clean. It's pretty clean. So as I said, came off from here. We made a new low last week, last Thursday. This was Friday. So this week onwards, we started to pay attention because we went inside that 50.
Yeah.
Ideally, I wanted news to give us that one more drop, one more pop up to come into more premium pricing, but we never did. And this is the news that we played out of that redistro. And then this was the micro inside it to go and make this low, and then secondly to go and make this low, and then to hold partials because we're bearish times three on this pair. So it was pretty good continuation play with news, fundamentals, and technicals involved, and market cycles as well. So yeah, I'll do this one, and then we'll go to the main one at, towards the end. So this one, just forget the name for it's not a currency pair, it's actually an index. But I just wanted to show you guys how obviously it makes sense when you see it everywhere, right?
What index is this, bro?
So this is a index following all the high yield bonds. I think it's got 100 bonds in there that's all got high yield, and it just follows it. So it's
Oh,
a
man.
tracker.
Cool.
And it's, I mean, if you were to purchase this for what? I don't know, back in 2020 here, you threw, I don't know, something in it, you'll be up about close to 40% after fees and whatnot. But yeah, this one, okay, this one is a bit, why is this one a bit? Let me maybe show it to you on my other one. I don't know why this one's acting up. Oh, is it because I didn't have that? I don't know, so where is this one? Yes. Don't know why it's so weird, but essentially what it was this, right? So let's go into. Right, so when we look at higher time frame, we know this is a bullish pair. Okay, there's no two ways about it. We're bullish from ever since the inception date. And then this is what's holding our intraday. This is our higher time frame. And then somewhere in there is our lower time frame. We'll look at this clearly. And when we come down here, and then when we look at this, the reason why I'm wanted to go over this was because this is a clean shakeout, right? We get our distro, we get our shakeout in here, and then we get a break. Very, very, very clean. And then price comes back right into a couple of ways, I guess you could have looked at this. Right into here. Oh, I've already got it there. So it comes right into that 80% here. Right there, bang on. And from there, I mean, I know this, you can't margin trade it, but from there, you would have got very close to like a 10% move from the entry. I tried to go and look for a micro in there. I couldn't really find anything. I think simply because of, I don't think the market is liquid enough. But yeah, I tried to go in and try to look for something in there. I don't think it presented itself anything. When we do come out and then when we do look at anything like this, there was this break, but it doesn't come back deep enough. But this would just be a simple limit off the extreme of the lower time frame, and then off we go. So that's that one. Let's come back into our pair here. So right, so I'll go off N chef first, and then we'll do A chef, or we might do it together. I don't know. We'll see. Okay. Let's look at where we were. Okay, so following this, we know we're bearish. We know we're bearish on here, and we know this is our lowest form of order flow. So same thing, rinse and repeat. We now got our leg. This is our order flow leg, and then we'll just be looking for our POIs. Okay, so we know this is a good area here. We've got London, we've got New York open, and we've got cause and effect, i.e. price has gone and made a new low. And from there, what can we see? We can also see a retracement has occurred. We're making higher highs and higher lows. So you can now find confluence within that. Okay, so we know there's nice confluence in here. Just between that 80 of the all of the leg, and this is order flow, right? Cool. At the same time, we're also inside that 50 here. Okay, so we know we've got some price action in here that potentially we could look for if we can get some sort of distro. So coming into this week, this was the game plan. Coming to this week, we know this was the game plan. So let's bring up to this week. So that was Thursday. Okay. Cool. So now again, very similar to GBP Chef. I either needed this to break to go up, and then this is what would be holding it, or I needed this to break to come down, and then we could look for a re-entry to go down with this. This was the game plan before news happened. This is what I wanted to see before anything occurred. So, whilst we can drop that down and just watching that and watching that, this way I would have my alerts right there and just waiting for something to give. So, we're currently inside Thursday now. Thursday, Asia. Cool. And then we get this. Okay, so price didn't really make a new high, nor did it make a new low. But what I do like is inside of this, I like this micro that we've got. Okay, and I definitely like the Asian sweep. So this is something I'm willing to throw out of a lower risk. Okay, and the only thing I would need from here is for price to make this law. Okay, if it goes and breaks this law, that's even perfect, right? If it goes and breaks this or breaks this, that's even perfect. But what would be sufficient for me would be if price just break that, then in my journal that would allow me to play the London play. Given that it's a Thursday, given that we are London, we are fairly inside that 50, if that makes sense. So given that we get a break Thursday coming up for New York, this would allow me for me to pull the trigger. Let's see if we do get that. Okay, so we get that. And now we'll just have to wait for the pullback. It's even better that we went and we got this. But it wasn't needed. The reason why it wasn't needed was because it never, you know, didn't hold anything. This was what was holding. So if we get that low, that was also super.
The clean buildup of liquidity, you can actually see the ice forming.
Oh, here?
Yeah, across the whole thing, yeah.
Cool. So we actually, there you go. So we actually get the low. Very, very shy, but we get it. Now, coming up back up into here. Cool. So let me see if I can find a candle that can maybe sit very nicely. Been a 46, yeah, let's keep it at that 46. Okay, so if you would just do that and that. So this is 80% of the 46 minute. Cool. And then I'm gonna go see if we've got any like imbalance or anything sitting in there. Cool, we had imbalance, but then it was mitigated. So we know we've got imbalance in here. Essentially that whole thing. Let me see if we've got it. 5 and 6. Got it in the 2, so the 3 would be enough. I want to just do that. One more there. And that's our imbalance there. And what else can we find? So we know we've got that there. Essentially, see if we can find some more confluence with that whole thing. So, okay, so we know the 80 line from the 46 minute is also lining up with the whole distro. And then we've got imbalance just below it, just in that 50. So that's something that we can look for. Essentially, this is ready for me to go and place it in the app. From there to there, and we'll be looking to make a new low, and essentially we'll go and make this low here. That would be the main target. Okay. Now if this gets clapped, we'll then be looking for this area here, because this is what's maintaining that leg. Okay, cool. So we're now maybe about 2 hours away or 1 hour away from New York Open. Let's see what we get. Oh, hold on. This is New York, and this is the news. Comes right in. Okay. Now, I didn't have a limit there for two reasons. Number one, because of spreads. Okay, you don't know what your spread would be like at that time. I think it comes right bang on that 130. Yeah, there you go. So you don't know what your spread would be like. Yeah, this is good when you're backtesting. I'm showing you a free pip count. But we all know during your news period, it just goes to ballistic amount. So I didn't have that there. And then the second reason is when you pull up HF, you would see that HF has divergence, which we'll look at in a minute. Okay. So that's why I didn't have it. But then I was watching the micro. And the moment we went and we got this, I think we even need to go. Yeah, so the moment, oops, the moment we, I got this break, I just went on that to this. Think there was even that to that. And I played the octave 80 right there. So this was literally 2 o'clock my time. So half an hour after the news died, the spreads died. So this is where I had the limit sitting there. And at the same time, once I had the limit sitting there, I then went to watch HF. But just let's just see what happens with NCHF. Pretty much. So this is what gets me in right there. And I think even when we go down, there was a micro. That was a bit. I didn't have the time to look at. Oops, I think it's a micro. I don't know. Maybe this was. I don't know. No. Okay. So this is what got me in. And then I say I just left that. I had an alert here to say go to reduce risk. But I think looking at this now, looking at this, once we got this break, maybe we could have played out of this. I don't know, maybe we see if we could play out of here inside that 50 and that 80, see if it comes back.
You see that 80%?
Of this one,
No, the one you've just marked.
this one.
It lines up quite nicely with the 50% of the UTED.
Okay. So this is the UTA, yeah.
No, to the right now. I'm talking about the micro.
Okay.
Let me get the
All right, from here.
yeah, so like for me, like here's the distro and so here's the distro and then the
Yeah.
manipulations from there. So the 50%
Let's
is
see.
sort of,
Okay, yeah, I see what you mean, yeah.
so it's good
Okay.
confidence.
Well, I mean, I wasn't watching this. I didn't catch this re-entry. If there is a re-entry, I don't know if there is. But the only thing I did was I just placed that limit there. And then I just literally walked away.
Yeah.
But let's see if we do come back.
No, it's a clean entry regardless.
Let's see if we do come back. So hold on. Okay, so we're like 5 minutes away from equities open. Still in the heart of New York. Still good for volume. I think we
Yeah.
just come shy. We come into that 50 and then we distribute.
Yeah.
Quite beautiful as well. Do we just go from here?
It's probably going to drop it. Yeah.
Oh, no. Yeah, it comes back one more time to the last point of supply. Oh no. Okay, we do
Clean.
come back. We do come back. Look at that. Okay. This is the re-entry, I guess.
Yeah.
This would have been very nice. And even if you got clapped here, this is
That's
very,
the
very
one, mate. Yeah.
this is very clean. I think it just comes to that 50, eh? I don't think it comes to the 80. No, it isn't. Ah, okay, let's see, hold on. No. Okay, yeah, that's it now. The moment it makes this low, that's it. Oh, hold on. It does come to 50. But see, I wouldn't like that.
Yeah,
This is it for
that's
me now because the fact that we know we've got an accumulation, we've had a distro that turns into a reaccumulation, and then we've tried to get this. No, don't like this could easily go up like that for me
I
now.
agree. I agree.
So
It's
the
like,
only thing,
why didn't it take out demand? Do you know what I mean?
yeah. So the only thing is, I do like what is cooking. Right?
Yeah.
So the moment that this breaks, if that 80, for example, is not mitigated, and then we do that, I'm coming back into here.
Yeah, makes sense.
So I do like maybe he is cooking up like a 1, 2, 3, maybe even giving us a fourth drive inside here. And if it does, then perfect, right? Because then what we need is that break and then coming up. Okay, hold on. Give us the break. So this is how I'll be seeing it, right? You go 1 drive, 2 drive, and then you've got your UT here, so your third drive, but your third drive is a very clean type one. And then you get the brake and you also get this brake, right? So now if we can come back up into here, let's see if we've got some sort of confluence between the whole leg and that last point of supply here. Okay, so that 50 is lining up fairly. There's a bit of gap between that 80, but essentially this is screaming something to me. Cool. Now, I would have gone to reduce risk here because this is a different leg now, right? So, but again, I don't know if I would have thrown something in here. I don't know. I don't think I would, to be honest. But let's see if we do even come back. Okay, come back to that bit after that.
Gone.
Yeah, most likely, yeah. Comes back into that 50. So even if I would have something, it would be on that 80 and not on that 50.
Yeah, the 50's a bit too wide for
It's
the
a
sprint.
bit,
Yeah.
yeah, I mean,
For the SL.
from there, I mean, you could have offset it, which would have given you 2 pips. But
Actually,
that's it
looking at
now.
that, bruv, yeah.
And that's it. So this is where I would
That's a
have
clean distro, though. That's very clean.
that was very clean. But I'll show you yeah, N Chef was actually very clean. A Chef had a bit of work to it, which I had to hold on, which we'll go and talk about. But
Yeah,
essentially they got
I saw the CPI for A Chef actually gave the manipulation to the upside.
yeah, to the upside. So
Yeah.
where this one came into here, A
Yeah.
Chef went and made, which is why this limit was not on, right? As I said, for 2 reasons. Number one, because I knew it was coming up to the news, and then because HS went and made a new high.
Yeah.
So that's why I didn't have that on. But this re-entry here was clean. Cool. So again, my first target would have been this, which was not a 10-to-1, but it was just under a 10-to-1, like a 7-to-1. And then this one would have given me my 10-to-1 here this morning. So there you go. Because I know I saw my alert went off and I took some partials. So here's where I would have some partials taken. And here's where I would have some partials taken. So just before New York close, my alert would go off here. And then your 10-to-1 would be here somewhere. And then I think that's all she wrote. Today there was some price action, but it wasn't anything. The PPI didn't do anything, as we saw. And essentially that's it. That's all she wrote. Here's Asia. There was no manipulation, nothing that I could add to the entry. It was just pretty much profit taking when just before London closed. Around 5 p.m. I think I went left to go to the gym. Yeah, so somewhere around there I just closed. So this was sitting, finger close. Yeah, about 5 o'clock there. About 25-to-1 on this one. So that would have been nice.
That's
This
a
one,
nice
if we,
catch, man. Yeah.
yeah, this one, if we did offset this, I don't know if we got it on here. This was on a freaking 5 seconds. There would have been, I know definitely there would have been some broker acting up in there. Was it? Was this one, was it? So if we done from that 50 here to that 80, but really add 2 pips to it. That would also be a clean one, can't lie. Just to that low here would have been an 81. And that would have been also that would have been 32-1. But that's that would have been a bit extreme, I can't lie. Cool. So that was end chef. Any questions on that in terms of where we were, what did you do? And again, I didn't go over structure, but this is bearish times three as well. Okay, this is just falling off anyway. You can see that. So any sort of continuations would be good. Cool. Any questions on this?
We
I
good,
think it was
bro.
very good.
Yeah, agreed.
Cool. Let's go over the last one, which was A Chef, right? And let's look at the same period. What did A Chef do, and how I managed to catch anything in there compared to N Chef? Cool. So A Chef, let's come up again. A Chef is also bearish times three. This is just old back test somewhere that I did. But we're looking inside this price action for this week. Cool. And again, same thing. We were inside this leg. Okay. And then come up here. We went inside that leg, and it was simple enough. Cool. So, all right. So this is where we were, right? And where we had a, this is where essentially I was looking at for price to also react out of, just like how we saw with N Chef, right? To go, and this would be our target, and then coming inside this POI would be another target for us, which is why I was watching A Chef's more attentively than N Chef, because N Chef. We N Chef was the leader and A Chef is the lagger, right? So where N Chef has already broken this low, A Chef still got ways to go. So in my head, I'm thinking, okay, cool. If I could get into something, right, and I could hold that for definitely banked, we know that A Chef can go to that because N Chef did. This is a 300 pip move, okay, also. So this was the game plan coming into this, and then I just needed something clean for us to get into. Now, a couple of things here. So let's come up to the news first. All right, there. When I saw this, there was definitely something printed in my head, and it was this. Okay, I'm not sure if this is how you guys would say this as well, but this is how I saw this, and then clean divergence here. When we even come up, we would see. There is divergence from this to that, and from this high to there. Okay, and then we already know there was divergence with this and N chart. Okay, so we're bearish times three, sorry, times two for now, but we're inside this 80 here, right? That didn't have a limit, but it should have. Actually, I know why it didn't have a limit. We'll talk about that in a second, and target wise, we know it's already at 10-1. So this is our confirmation. The reason why I didn't have a limit was because of this. I didn't quite trust this. This was Asian. Okay. So if this was like a structure, I would have maybe played it, but this is just simply order flow. Okay, order flow, and then I knew that news was coming. So what's to say price did that, you know? Because price definitely took our Asian here and left it on it and enter. So what's to say this that there was the importance of this? Nothing. So that's why I didn't have it there. But if we did, I mean, this is something that was would be in my something that I could throw that 13 pips. I could allow that. Sometimes I do when I'm like off away from keyboard. Because I'd rather catch a 5-1 in a quiet week when I'm not in the front of the screen than having nothing. Okay. So this is something that could have been played in my book. Oh, it didn't come. That's a shame. I thought it did. I wonder it did. Oh. That's a shame. Okay, maybe it didn't bump. Cool. All right. So the one, the what I did catch was inside the micro once again, and it was clean. Not as clean as Encher, but it was definitely there. And again, it was simply because when we went and we punched in this flow, give another one. Cool. So when it was when we went and we made that. Now, what I saw was this. Couple of things. Had the limit sitting on the 80. Just there. And to go down to wherever. We'll have a look at that in a second. And then I was watching this. This is also very good, right? So we saw got one drive, two drive. This is fairly equal, so I needed to have a break, and this is what we got here. Okay. But when it was when we got that break, let me come back up.
Clean micro within there as well,
Yeah,
within the
this is
fourth
what
drive.
exactly. And this is what was very, very clean. Maybe I don't know clean up. Okay. So I like the fact that not only was this because I didn't see the as I said, this for me is fairly equal and this was not high enough. So I saw this as one drive, two drive, and I saw this as three drive. But I like the micro inside of 50. Okay, like we know price doesn't need to come to the 80, but if it did, I had the limit there. And then this allowed me to watch the micro inside here. And then essentially when we got the micro, when we got this break here, I just free up that 50.
That's a winner, that one. 1.6 pick stop. Come on.
Yeah, and I think it wasn't, but because it wasn't even a limit, it was a market execute. And I'll tell you exactly where I got in. I got in at,
Suppose you've got to add spreads as well.
yeah, and I had to market execute it. I couldn't place it. I mean, was watching this and watching freaking. So I got in at 439. Yeah, so on my broker, it was at 439. Which I guess this is a wonder, so it's not the same. So it was somewhere around here that I got in at, and it was like a free pip, 3.5, I think. And essentially that's what it was. And then the moment I saw this, moment I saw it, see this go. That's when I started to move.
You know, you would have got away with a sell stop with it. Oh, no
Oh
way.
no, it did come in. Hold on, maybe that's not the one. Oh no, it did come in. Where did I get it this time? Oh hold on, this is the ninth. Is this the one? Is this 10th? So this one. Oh, it would have been this one. Okay, hold on. So I was right. So yeah, it did. We did get this. We did get what I wanted because we got one drive, two drive, and this is the third drive, and this is the fourth drive. And we, I think I even saw that it came right into that 50. The is that a bias climax? And as I said, I didn't pay attention to that. For me, this was one whole move. There's our minor sign of weakness. And UT, and then this is what I liked as well, because this came into that 50. And this is our UT here. And I needed that break there. And I think I just played the 50 once again. Right there. Something like that is what I played.
Nice.
And I didn't do anything until it come down here.
Yeah, it's worth it for 4.4 pip
Yeah.
stop, you
And again, my target was to make that 10-1 on here. Because remember, we still had to play this bigger distro. So,
And it's a Thursday.
yeah, definitely. Yeah, for me, I needed to take this down, and I needed to take that down. That for me is what allowed me to get that 10-1. When we come back into here, it's a shame that we didn't get this one, but I'm not too upset about it since we managed to catch this one into here. And that's it. I think do we take this low before close? No, we don't. So I think all I did, yeah, was I just removed this to reduce risk here. And I think when I said this morning, I didn't do anything like late night. I think I just left it. And then this morning, just during London, I think I moved it about to secure profit. There was actually this redistribution as well, okay? And when we redistributed, I took some partials. The redistribution was kind of clean, so it was clean, but I just didn't give us anything for us to play out of. There was the break. See if we could come back up into here to go down, but I don't think we do. Yeah, we just go. So when we redistributed, I just took some partials, and then when we made this low, I took some partials again, which was at us 10-1 right here. So yeah, so this one, I think I took a loss on here as well, which was this one.
That micro in third.
Yeah, so it was that one. No, it wasn't that one, it was this one. It was, oh yeah, no, it was this one, you're right. Yeah, it was that one.
I
That
would have
one.
done the same thing, bro.
Yeah, it
That's
was that one.
that fits our rules, bro. Like, we got a micro within a third drive. It's a clean manipulation. But obviously, when we get that high manipulated, that's when we got to look and zoom out and look at the bigger picture.
Yeah, 100%, 100%.
That's
You're right.
the key.
Yeah, and
Because
I mean, come and look at this. This when you're in that moment, when you're in there, you just want to see, like, even this break here. You just wanted to catch this. Do you know what I mean?
yeah.
But when you come back out, and then you see, okay, cool. What phases are you in? Do you know?
Yeah, that's it.
When you then see that, then that causes you to be much more patient. And over the years, this is why I've managed to set limits, because when I set a limit, then I find myself much calmer to look at price action. Because if this, like for example, if this ute had clapped in there, okay, cool, I'm in. Do you know what I mean? Now, even if it didn't do that, right, and then let's just say it came into that UTO, for example, and then just went down, and I didn't catch anything here. Well, guess what? I still got an opportunity for me to catch the re-entry here. Do you know what I mean?
Exactly, yeah.
So I found that those two things really helpful, knowing where you are in the market cycle, which market phases, setting a limit at the extreme or where your line in the sand is, and then just wait. Essentially just wait. So but yeah, that was those back tests there. Mainly these three. This was just a little extreme entry. But yeah, nChef very, very clean. It gave us multiple entries. aChef very, it would have bit of worked, but for me, the reason why I went ahead with it was because of where we were, right? When we saw that break, this was it. And then when we saw there was divergence here, this is what I needed to look at.
Yeah, again, fits our rules. We got,
Yeah, 100%, 100%. This was. Sorry, bro, go on.
RSI on the comparative RSI plus, sorry, a comparative divergence plus RSI divergence, and we get the manipulation
with fundamentals in use as well. So
exactly.
yeah,
Ticks the boxes, man.
for sure, for sure. So there was I mean, there was a couple of ventures, as I said. There was this one, two, three that we saw, and four. So as I said, I'm a firm believer that a market would definitely give you a 10-to-1, and I do believe that with everything, like, this is a clean signature trade for us, you know. These two pairs have definitely been, and I know for the past maybe month or so, Mike has always been talking about these two anyway. So, yeah. So, but this week has really shown itself in terms of giving us that 10-to-1 minimum. But yeah, super clean, man.
No, I couldn't agree more, bro. That's good.
Super,
Good
super clean.
find.